What's up, everyone? I'm Bea the Installer. This is Jen.
Hi.
And this is Caesar, a tech dog. And we have the Samsung S95C, the 77-inch version. So big, so awesome. I'm super excited to unbox this. We're gonna put it up in my room, do all that, and I'll tell you more about it along the way. All right, go ahead. Let's do it.
Okay, let's go.
Make sure you guys like and subscribe, of course, because you like this kind of content. Of course you do.
You got some tension on these. Oof.
Now, I will tell you, this box seems pretty tippy. It's a little lighter. It's pretty plain. It's a pretty plain box, especially since you're standing next to it with those fancy pants on. But, you know, I like that they're not using a ton of, you know, colors and stuff that are bad for the environment on this. So, pretty straightforward. What do you got?
We've got our install guide. We've got cords and remote and all that kind of fun stuff.
Or as I like to call it, the bag of goodies.
The bag of goodies. This looks like a cover plate for the back.
Well, wait. It's a cover plate, but do you know what it's a cover plate for? Grab that thing over there.
Something that's open.
Check that thing out. What is it?
Is it the One Connect box?
Yeah, this one has a One Connect box.
How fancy.
Yeah, last year's, you know, QD OLED did not have a One Connect box. This year's it does. And that's gonna play a big role when we take it upstairs, because we already have all the cords kind of in a spot, and so we need to put the One Connect box in a certain spot. It'll be awesome.
Wait, this is going in our bedroom?
Yeah.
You said your room, so I was wondering.
Yeah. Did I just say my room?
Before.
Well, you know, my half the room. Okay. You don't watch TV at night.
You're half the room, but this TV is gonna keep me awake on all.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. Half. The best part about this TV is I'm just gonna put it on sun mode at night so you can't sleep when I'm watching stuff.
So then I feel like the sun's rising at 3 a.m.
Okay.
Okay, awesome.
What do you got?
Here we've got, I'm assuming this is like the foot, the single foot.
The foot of the stand. Yeah, there's like two pieces. It's a little more complicated, but it's quite heavy and that's only half of it, so.
Yeah, it's heavy.
Let's move all this stuff aside and let's get this thing out of the box.
What's in the box?
So if you have a, you know, 85-inch or larger TV, normally they have some little connectors on the side here that you can take the box off. But you know, this one is not, that doesn't look like it's more than 4 feet tall. So if you have an 8-foot roof, you can't get this box off. You gotta lay it down or something. But I think we're gonna be able to just get it by. So let me back up and we'll get this lifted over the top. Let's not let it slip. Come on, muscles, let's go.
No, it's not muscles, it's careful.
Careful.
Captain Cautious.
You can just drop it, I got it. Yeah. Good stuff, Jen. You know what, why don't you take that, I got the TV. One of us has to stay. You wanna take this off? I'll take them if you want. I like this. This is a, you know, nice piece to have there. I don't know why they just don't go all the way, but at least in the middle where it's probably the most exposed, it's got that protection.
Probably something about physics and pressure.
Yeah, you gonna hold that and I'll take this. All right, so the reason we're actually down here is because we have this really cool looking TV, even though it's going up in our bedroom. And you want me to hold that? You got it? And it just looks too cool. So we have to kind of show you where there's more space, what this TV looks like. And then we're gonna go and replace that 65-inch A90J Sony upstairs.
Okay, let's see. So to get this TV out, we're going to, looks like there's some tabs on the side. We're gonna open those up and flatten the box out and then take off the final side pieces. And then it looks like there's one of these pieces of styrofoam that we just kind of take right out so we can get access to all the spots to put the stand part on.
Sounds good. Let's do it.
Let's
go. The directions are there. You get that side, I get this side.
Okay.
I'm gonna pull these tabs. Open it up, there you go. Man, this, yeah, you know what? Beware with this TV. It is very tippy. Hold on, can you hold on the TV for a second? I gotta put this down. Okay, cool, I feel better. Eric's back here, man in the camera. I'll hold this while you do that or vice versa, so.
Okay.
What are we doing? We have to take off the end or we just take the middle piece off?
We already took the end.
Gotcha.
So we've got that.
And then I think I just kick that out normally. Go ahead, push it through. There you go. Yeah, it makes it pretty easy. Now, it even makes it more tippy than it was before, so be careful. Why don't we just take the box? We'll just take this off. It's fine.
Okay. You wanna lift it up?
Yeah, just lift it up. I'll put this back on my piece. There we go. And then I can do the same on the other end. Let me do this. I'll pick it up and you pull that out and get that. Jeez, you almost punched me in the junk. All right, cool. So I think we got to put this piece on that piece first and then put the whole thing up here.
Let's see.
Did that say in the instructions? What is that?
I'm sure it did.
All right, so we actually have three pieces for the stand. This one goes on the TV. That one goes on this one. Then it all comes together. We're going to let Jen handle that. She's going to get the screws out and we're just going to start putting it together. So they got little hooks right there. You just hook the two in and then it just stays in there. And four screws. Such a thin TV, I'm surprised it has that much room to like put these screws in, you know? They didn't want to catch, but they did now. Okay, so there we go. Put these in there. That's just magnetic.
It's magic.
It is sort of magic. It's really heavy. It's quite the stand. And then, looks good.
Got it?
Yeah, I got it. Cool, good job. Thank you, Jen, for putting the stand on.
Of course.
Should we get this out of the styrofoam and get it ready to stand up?
Probably.
What do you think, Caesar? Yeah? All right, let's do it. Let's take it out of these two. I'm gonna
lift up.
Move it forward a little. Awesome.
So, okay, Bryn, we can't show everybody the TV down here on the ground. It's just not gonna do it. Let's get this Besta stand from IKEA over here so we can display the TV. Sound good?
Yep.
Awesome.
Here, Jen, show some leg. Come on. No, I meant with the TV.
Oh.
Ooh, let's get it off.
Yeah.
Let's move this
off.
It's
getting a little dangerous.
I don't really want to drop this TV, yeah. Look, no cracks. So far, so good.
Yeah.
You want to take it up?
Yep, let's go.
All right, one, two, three. What you got there, Jen?
So here we've got the One Connect box. So we've got our ports back here. So we've got the One Connect right there. We've got some USB, we've got our HDMI, including the eARC, and then we've got our USB here, the X-Link, the antenna, and then the LAN.
And you have the optical out there too, that's another one.
Oh, where, yeah.
One thing about those HDMI ports, all four of them can game at 4K 120, so that's pretty awesome.
I dig it.
You dig it. All right, and then on the back here, so we can actually put this either on the TV right there, like if we had the two screws right there, or we can put it on the back of this little stand here. It sits like that and then you have the little cover. So we can put the screws there or we can just put it up here. I think when we get upstairs, we're gonna put it up there, but let's just put this down and let's peel that plastic off the front of the TV. That's your favorite part. And then we'll fire the TV up. What do you think, Jen?
I'm excited to unsheathe the TV.
Let's do it.
One big sheet.
What? Get her, Caesar.
What? Get it.
So this TV does look really cool. I love on the back there, they have the new speaker drivers or woofers or whatever. They got eight different speakers back there. Very thin TV. Now it's supposed to be more durable this year. It's supposed to be a better panel. There's supposed to be a lot of upgrades, obviously brighter. I did notice on top here that it doesn't look like it's a perfectly straight line down the middle. It looks like the TV's almost bent in the middle a little bit. I'm not sure if you guys can pick that up on the video here, but you know, it's not a huge deal. I was just curious if that is gonna be an issue with regards to the quality of the TV, but overall she looks pretty nice. And the TV's not too bad herself. So for the One Connect box, we either have to put it on the back of the TV or on the stand. Since we're down here, let's just put it on the stand. All we have to do is put the two screws in on the back of the stand. The stand will fit in there, but first we need to plug the One Connect wire in, the power cord, then set it on the stand, and then it has a little cover plate. Easy enough. All right, let's move on to the remote. You ready?
Let's do it.
Okay. What you got there?
So here I have the Samsung solar cell remote. Say that three times fast. I've tried it and it's tough. So just your basic buttons that you need. It's a nice compact size. You've got your power button. You've got some of your shortcut buttons down here, the directional pad. Really, you know, it's cutting corners on all the things you don't need. So cool thing back here, this is the little solar cell. And then down here, if you want to be able to charge it through USB, you can. So I'm gonna go ahead and give that a pull, boop, and turn the TV on.
But first, I want to quickly mention the theater seating that we use in our home, since it's a question I often get asked. This is the popular Tuscany console edition from Valencia Theater Seating. It's a premium leather console that has many great features like lower lumbar support, an adjustable headrest, and of course, very smooth motorized recline. The armrests have cup holders and open to offer a ton of storage for things like remotes and game controllers. You have controls on your side as well as USB chargers. In addition, the center seat can convert to a console with lights, a little table, additional cup holders, power outlets, and more USB ports. Now, we don't have a dedicated home theater yet, but when we do, there's no question it will have Valencia home theater seating in it. But even for our living room, this premium seating is a family favorite. And Valencia has all kinds of fantastic seating and many different leather color options to match your home theater. So go to the website and customize your theater arrangement. Connect with their fantastic customer service if you have a question, and get your new premium seating today. Use the links in the description below and tell them Be the Installer sent you. All right, cool, we have it all set up. We're actually going to take it upstairs, but we wanted to just go to like one of those HDR channels on YouTube and see how cool it looks. My dear.
Of course.
Okay, so the TV looks amazing, quite colorful, and the size I think is gonna be the big thing. So I think we should take this party up into the bedroom. What do you think?
Kinda tired.
Sure, tired. We'll see what she says when we get up there. But let's take this TV up there, show some content, have some fun with it. Let's go. You ready to go?
Yep.
All right. Let's do it, man. Let's get this out of here.
All right.
Eric's gonna help me instead of Jen.
Having to fill in.
Safety first, then teamwork.
Yeah.
All right, ready?
All right, yep.
One, two, three. You never do the one, two, three. See? Jen and I do the one, two, three.
Yeah.
This is the fun part.
Oh yeah.
All right, well, why don't we just put it over there?
All right.
Don't have a lot of extra room in here for a big old TV. Awesome, cool. Okay, so we have the new 77 inch there. We have the 65 inch Sony here. I'm gonna take that down and replace it with that with the same mount and everything. And once we have it up, we'll show you all the different footage. So we're gonna do that now. Okay, in order to get this Samsung 77 inch up, we have to take the Sony A90J down. And when I pull it out, I noticed that the mount is not gonna work for the Samsung because unlike most OLED TVs where the mounting holes are lower, this Samsung's actually built more like a QLED where the mounting holes are raised up a little bit higher. So I'm gonna have to take this old TV and this old mount down and just get rid of it because there's a power outlet there and I can't just work the other mount around that. And because we want the TV to be in the same spot, I measured off the top of the dresser to the bottom of the Sony and it was 4.5 inches. And then the new brackets from the bottom of the TV up to where it hooks on are 20.5 inches. Then you add the distance between where the bracket goes on and the top of the mount, which is 2.5, which makes 23 inches. And then we need that 4.5 inch difference from the dresser up to the TV. So that's a total of 27.5 inches from the top of the dresser, and it works out perfectly with this power outlet. So now we can go ahead and throw the TV mount up. And then we just have to put the new brackets on the new TV, screw those in, get it all set. And then we have to take the stand off the Samsung. And there are two little knob screws that are on the top here that put the one connect box on the back of the stand. But we're actually gonna move and use the three screws that come in a different bag up to the right side of the back of the TV so that we can put the one connect box on the back, because I already have the HDMI run up the wall and the power is up high. Then we just take the four screws off of the stand, lift it up, and we're gonna go hang that TV. After putting it up on the wall, I realized that it's gonna be a little bit trickier for us to get the one connect box up there than I thought, because the shorter wire doesn't reach all the way around like it did when it was on the stand. So we have to grab the longer wire. In addition, we also have to find somewhere to put that wire. And then it's kind of tricky to get it to connect to the TV because now the mount is sort of over that area, which has always been a problem when you have something like that one wire being inside the Visa pattern. That always presents a problem. But we worked it out. Good to go on this side. Just have to connect the HDMI and then go on the other side where we plug in the power. And this Samsung power cord is built upside down. I've never really seen a cord have the ground go down and the wire go up. Made it a little bit hard to plug in, but I'm not really sure why they did that, but you know, it worked this time. And when putting this TV up, we noticed that we smudged it a bit, which can be a little bit difficult with Samsungs. Use a little hot breath, use a nice clean sock, wipe it up, good to go. And now it's time to turn the TV back on. So I want to get right into content. Normally we go over the operating system, but we're going to do that in a minute because we have a couple cool features that I want to show you, including gaming with the Xbox straight off of the cloud. So hold on for that. But in this SDR content, we're going to be using YouTube TV because I actually use this for the S95B last year and most other TVs as well. And last year I realized that it wasn't great with the lower bandwidth content. I think other people have commented about that. But looking at this, this TV is extremely bright and some of these colors are just amazing. And I'm not sure, again, I have to decide if it's something that it's larger or if it's just brighter or a combination of the two. And we have the same footage on the Sony A90J. And you can see, obviously it's a lot bigger, but it's also brighter. So it's kind of the best of both worlds. When people ask us, should I buy a better TV or 1 year newer of the same size, we normally say, just go for the bigger TV. But last year when I had the A80J in here, it was just a slightly underwhelming TV compared to the A90J. But what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments if you see a noticeable difference in brightness, or if it's more just that the size difference is something that you picked out first. And I'm gonna be doing a full review on this, so if there's any other questions you have, definitely hit me up in the comments and let me know what you guys wanna see. Next, I wanna get into some HDR footage. You know, this TV, if anything, is gonna be great for watching HDR movies. I know Samsung doesn't support Dolby Vision, but I don't think that's a big deal. Most Samsung TVs that I've seen look amazing with HDR 10 or HDR 10 Plus. And this S95C is absolutely no different because it's one of the best TVs for watching HDR content. Of course, again, it's very bright, but you can see how much more color this has. Just so much more color volume, absolutely amazing. And when you compare it to the smaller TV, again, I think it's just naturally brighter and it has more color volume than the A90J, but again, it's larger. So when you have them side by side, again, let me know what you guys think. Do you see a big difference here? And this is again against a WOLED, but if you have this TV against other TVs with regards to its HDR performance, it's so amazing to have something that can get perfectly black against bright colors right next to it, where you wouldn't have that with an LED, even a really good LCD-based TV. But it's just OLED TVs and these new QD OLED TVs are so amazing to be able to do this with pixel level control. And I'm pretty much done comparing it to the A90J. Now, yes, the A90J had a heat sink. You know, the speakers come out of the screen versus with the Samsung, they're on the back of the TV. But I have to say the S95C 77 inch, better TV, it's a new year. So let's move on to some other content. So back to the home screen so you guys can see the operating system. The reason why I wanted to wait is because there's a couple of cool new things that I wanted to show you. More or less, it looks the same from the front here where you have a full screen for the Tizen OS in 23 here. You do have you know, a lot of things that are cool, like it shows you what you recently watched. It does have all the apps up top. One of the things that I really like about Samsung TVs is the Samsung TV Plus, where you get all kinds of, you know, different channels. So it's something to consider if you're buying a new TV, you don't have cable, this would be a great option. In addition to just having all the media there, you also have the game bar, which I'm going to show you in a second, and then the ambient mode. So here, of course, it's not exactly like the Samsung frame, but you still have like backgrounds and scenes. They're pretty cool. You can click on them and just have something to display when you're not watching TV. Although with an OLED TV, something that might have a shelf life, not sure you're going to want to have this on all the time. It might be nice if it's displayed out in a living room where you don't want to have a black screen up. But for us at night, probably just going to turn the TV off. Okay, so then the game hub, which is really cool on this TV. You can go in and you can game off the cloud. You can, you know, connect your Xbox or PS5 or whatever, of course. But we wanted to see how cool it looks if you just play off the Xbox cloud. So what we had to do is log into the Xbox account first, which did bring up my son's entire account, all of the games that he normally plays, even where he left off on some of the games. We did, of course, have to pair the Xbox remote. I think you can pair anything that has Bluetooth capable, like whether it's a PS5 controller, Xbox controller, and others. And then we just went in and tried to see what gameplay looks like compared to playing on the X Series X, or we even have an X1S too. So we had both the kids try different games, games that they're used to playing on their Xbox Series X, one on the Xbox One S. And both of them thought that while the games were still pretty cool, you know, obviously it looks awesome on screen, very bright, very awesome looking picture. Definitely the frame rate looked a little choppy. There was more of a lag. You really couldn't play the game the way that you would on an actual console, because you can see sometimes that the frame rate just looks like it's even less than 30 frames per second, or that it was, you know, really low bandwidth coming through the internet. Wasn't perfect. There was an opportunity when we were finished playing each game to give feedback of how the gameplay was. And we let them know that it was a little bit choppy, but cool that they have the opportunity to improve this. And hopefully as time goes on, it'll be something that everyone's comfortable playing, even if you play games that are first person shooter, high frame rate or whatever. But you are, you know, at the mercy of your own internet speed and playing this off the cloud. But my son did say that even when he plays cloud gaming on the Xbox Series X, it still has the same problem. So it's not necessarily just the TV. It could just be, you know, we're not there yet for cloud gaming in general. But it's still an awesome part of this operating system to have this, to make improvements. And I think, you know, it ranks as one of the best operating systems because of that, as well as having the, you know, Samsung TV Plus channels and all the other apps that you can access. And last but not least, we have the multi-view function, which is also another thing that I love on these Samsung TVs, the ability to split your screen up. So, you know, you can now be playing a game and you can also be watching YouTube, or you can connect your phone in YouTube or a source. So it's pretty awesome that you can do two things at once. I love picture in picture back in the day. I actually used it, watched two football games at the same time. Maybe other people don't, but I'm really impressed that Samsung and other companies are bringing that back in 2022, 2023. So another cool feature. And with the multi-view, I can exit out and go full screen and give you guys my wrap up, which is I'm very impressed with this TV. I don't know if it's just because it's a 77-inch QD OLED. I know that that's been on the minds of everyone that reviews TVs, and I know a lot of consumers out there wanted a 77-inch. It's definitely awesome. I know that it's brighter because I spoke to Samsung display earlier in the year and we saw it versus last year's model. It's supposed to be more durable. It's supposed to be up to 2 times as bright as the last year's model. And of course you have a 77-inch version. So I'm pretty impressed. I got a lot more work to do here. We're going to put out a full review, but let me know in the comments what you guys want to see more of. Let me know what you're impressed by. Make sure to smash the like button, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. And also, if you're here and you need to buy a TV, go to my website and check out the new Be the Installer TV quiz, where you can enter in information about how far away you sit, what kind of content you watch, whether you have a bright room or a dark room. Enter all those questions. It'll pop out the best TVs for you, and you can click on the TVs there if you're gonna buy it. It helps support the channel, so I appreciate that. I'll see you guys on the next one.